everybody. I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned in to the NFL on EA Sports. This week, we've got teams who went in opposite directions last week. On the call here tonight, let's send it out to our guys in the booth. That's Brandon Guyden and Charles Davis.
Just a stone's throw away from the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame as we get set for football at First Energy Stadium in Cleveland, Ohio. Tonight, we wrap up the first 13 weeks of the season with a good Monday nighter between the Carolina Panthers and the Cleveland Browns. Hi again, everyone. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, we look at this Browns ball club. The streak continues, doesn't it? They come in here a perfect 11-0. On the other side of the field for the visiting Panthers, it's late in the year. The 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over.
Back in the NFL, here we go.
Kill, turn up.
Here we go.
Now a first carry for Isaiah Crowell. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
Whenever we meet with coaches and they always talk about wanting to establish running the football, it's oftentimes with a good tight end who can control the line of scrimmage and the point of attack, and they're becoming harder to find because the colleges are giving us a whole lot of receiving tight ends, former wide receivers who can run, not necessarily block very well. In this case, though, we saw two tight ends on the field, both of them with the ability to block, and he ran the ball successfully behind that power set.
Back to throw now on 2nd and 10. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Cleveland. Josh Gordon, his 11th touchdown of the year. And the Browns are within an extra point of tying this thing up. And on that one, able to catch it, also able to have the wherewithal to take it in for the score.
And how about the phases of a successful catch and a completion of a play? Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then, of course, the run after the catch that ends up in the end zone.
Drop you into the start of this next possession. The score, 7-0. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And on the ground they go with a running back. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
Well, they held him to a short gain on that one. And it almost felt like on that first run, they're trying to just throw the jab at him. So how do you stop a jab? Get closer and smother it, just as they did on that last play.
They'll run it again with Crowell. Not much there, maybe a couple up to the 35. Now the offense in that middle ground here on 3rd down, 3rd and 5. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And this is brought in by Pryor. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42.
Well, we're used to seeing the guy that you consider the number one receiver double covered, but how about this guy? He's double covered and finds a way to make the play for a first down.
That's how you increase your Madden rating, right?
No doubt about that at all. And you know something? I will hear about that from him soon.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Yes, this is where the expression staying ahead of the chains comes into play. Good runs like that one set you up well for 3rd down.
On 2nd down, Johnson. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. At 5 yards on the play there, the drive will continue.
Now, we all know that an offensive coordinator and a quarterback, they're aligned at the hip. But when you've got a runner who can get you that kind of yardage, that guy's invaluable.
Now a play fake here on 1st down. Throwing over the middle, and It's incomplete. That time they were looking for the former Auburn Tiger, Ricardo Lewis. And it's second down.
Sometimes it looks pretty simple, batting the ball away. But oftentimes there's some pretty good teaching and practice that goes into it. Being able to get to the receiver, not interfere, and get his hands through the football and not get away.
And his throw's going to be incomplete.
Well, Brandon, all receivers are trying to make sure that the defender thinks they're going to the middle of the field when they're running the outcut. And that play didn't get it done very well because that one was batted down. And the Panthers bring in their nickel set as they try to defend here on third down.
Five defensive backs. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth.
He wasn't the primary target, but I think it was almost like a check down situation, wasn't it?
Yeah, hoping he can break some tackles, a big tight end, but he couldn't do it.
Yeah, get it to that big frame and hope he can scatter some bodies, unable to get it done.
But he'll get this away into the icy winter air. And they won't risk defending a return here. Drop you into the start of this next possession. The score, 7-0. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And that is incomplete.
Holding offense.
So a little grabbing there, but this time it goes against the offense for Holden. They'll wind up losing a full 10 yards on the play. They'll run with Crowell. And a short gain here across the 10 to the 12. 2 yards on the pickup. It'll be second down. See if they stay on the ground for second down.
Partner, you know I love to point out when teams break tendency and do something a little bit different from the norm. But when you run the ball in the first play,
into double coverage and it's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. And his guys are going to... So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. And here are the Browns now as the offense comes back out onto the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities. When we talk about Luke Kuechly, you can't talk about his overall game without talking about his intelligence and how he controls the whole defense. He quarterbacks that defense, and at times will actually make checks just like a quarterback would on offense to get them into the right defense. They definitely were on that play. How about that finish? Holding that to a minimal gain. It's really come into vogue to talk about the different gaps that the defense tries to attack in an offensive line. And most of the time we're talking about blitzes. How many times have you heard double A-gap blitz? Well, where is the A-gap? It's the space between the center and the guards, either side. So when you're having a double A-gap blitz, it's two guys coming through that gap. In this situation, though, that A-gap wasn't open for the defense to exploit. The offensive line took care of it, protected it, and moved the defensive guys out of the way to allow for that nice run.
They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down. So nothing there, but maybe you blame that on the blocking.
Yeah, at some point, you've got to win at the point of attack, and on that play, that was all the defense. They made it happen.
On play action, they'll throw. Going down the middle, and it's complete. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. They go play action here on first down. And almost intercepted. It would have been his second pick of the game. Instead, it'll be second down. A reminder that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll check in with Larry Ridley in Orlando with highlights and analysis of this first half of play.
And I'm going to check in with a heater.
I'm going to be right there with you, partner. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll set up a third down. Play number seven now coming up on the drive. Third and five. Out of the gun now on third down. Flushed out right. He may try and run for this. Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's fourth down. Now Gostkowski will come on to try a field goal. From the right hash, it's a 38-yard attempt. And the 12-year veteran knocks it right through, and they'll cut the lead back. The 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. And the Browns getting set to go. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
The play action fake, they'll look to throw. He's got time in the pocket. Gonna throw right side here, complete. And he eventually goes down, but not before reaching the 30-yard line. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. He's gonna wind up and air it out. Oh, he had 6 points in his hands there. Couldn't hang on. Second down.
In this situation, it's really tough to figure out how to defend because they have plenty of room to still take deep shots at the end zone as they just did there. Yet at the same time, you've got to be ready for the short throw. In this case, when you see the cue that they're going for the end zone, retreat and make sure you have a way to play forward, back towards the receiver, and have a chance to bat the ball away as they did there.
And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. On third down, he'll drop to throw. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And this is caught. Touchdown, Cleveland. Their dangerous wide receiver as the first half is winding down. And the Browns are back within a score.
I think everyone in the league talks about finishing, don't they? Doesn't matter whether it's a quarter, a half, a game, a series.
Offense ready to get back out there as they'll have the football to start the third quarter. Here's the Browns offense now getting set to start off this third quarter. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. Call it an 8-yard gain, much better shape now on third and just a yard. So following the run, we'll see what they do here on third down.
And after that type of a run, there's some talking going on down on the field, but it's not trash talking. The guy who just carried the ball, he's going back and telling his offensive line, great job, keep it up, and we'll break that one soon. Now, coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there, and how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end, let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. They'll run it now out of the gun. And good penetration here. He'll get this down only to about the 49-yard line. It'll only be a gain of a yard, and it sets up a third down and 4 now. Third and 4. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. An extra defensive back in the game now here for third and 4. They'll look to throw, and he's got his man on the out route. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. The offense lining up first and 10. spinning past him. And he's going to get hit at the line of scrimmage and driven backwards. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Nice job there defensively to clamp down, because really, they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them. Oh, man, that wasn't far from breaking in a big way into the secondary. Read option, quarterback kept it. And while he didn't get a first down, he did get a nice chunk of yardage. Only a nice tackle prevented it from maybe going all the way. Really good, smart play by the defense, understanding third and short, guarding the first down sticks, and being able to make a play on the football and bat it down.
And Gostkowski's kick is good. And that's going to tie things at 20. Field as they'll take over here in the final minute of this third quarter. And now the Browns offense trots back onto the field. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. And at least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the...
And we're back now here in Cleveland. It's the Browns with a deficit. They're trailing, but with the football here to start the fourth. They'll go to the air here on third and two. And he will find his man on the outside. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
Finds a tight end in the middle of the field. Just a simple stick route. Decent game. Doesn't get you a whole lot, but it's pretty reliable, isn't it?
And tough to defend. On first down, he'll drop to throw. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
On any passes in the middle of the field, anyone who's going after the football is going to be conscious that it's probably going to be contested, and often physically. Sometimes that leads to drops.
They'll run it now out of the gun. They showed off a nice juke of the defender before the next wave could bring him down.
Another block in the ball. Offense. Still second down.
So the defense has put them in a tough spot. It's second and long. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And he's got his man on the out route. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout. An injured player. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And he will find his man on the outside. The 15 yards there on the catch and run. Now a play fake here on first down. Sliding out of the pocket. Wide open receiver complete. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15. Give him 27 yards that time. And the Browns are going to have a first down.
As a general rule, offensive linemen like to know where their quarterback's going to be when he's setting up to throw the football. But sometimes they just have to get on the run, get on the move. He was able to do that on that play and picks up a first down with a nice throw.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be dropped at about the 11 after only a yard. Tackle made by Thomas Davis. Second down following the run. Again, it's Crowell. And running room hard. hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. Give him 3 yards, and now they're left needing a conversion here on 3rd and 6. And they'll be in search of 6 yards here on 3rd down. This is now the 9th play of the drive. Back to throw. And he finds Barnage. He's got it. He didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the first down as he's tackled at the 1.
And in a lot of ways, that catch is expected. Red zone presence. And that one was realized there. You've got to find your tight end in that situation.
They come out here in the eye. They'll try and punch it in with Crowell. And he's in. Touchdown, Browns. Isaiah Crowell. Touchdown number 15 of the year. And the Browns are within an extra point of tying this thing up. And there you go. Nothing really too complex. Block, keep your assignments, let them run it in. They did it.
Fundamental football.
And we drop you into the start of this next possession. The score, 7-0. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead them to 3rd down.
When the 4-3 defense is functioning really well, you know who stays what we call clean and no one gets to him? The guy playing the middle linebacker position. The guy we call Mike. That means the defensive front has eaten up all the blocks and just let him go to the football and make a play.
A pickup of 11, and it moves the chains. Tie game here. Time starting to run down. The defense really needs to try and keep this game tied. See if they can get the ball back for the offense. On the run, it's Crowell. Give him 3 on 1st down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. Time for a break. We'll come back and see how it all shakes out after this.
Let's go!
And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45.
All right, it's football 101 to know that the quarterback controls just about everything on offense. But a lot of times what gets missed is that the center controls line play. He has to communicate to the guards and the tackles what type of front they're facing, how they're going to block it, and what adjustments need to be made sometimes on the fly as a defense will shift. Give the center a lot of credit because, for the most part, he's got big defensive linemen over his face all game long that he's got to try and block and protect his quarterback and create space for his runner. In this case, he did a really nice job of communicating and executing.
He'll try again with the arm here on 2nd down. And he rifles one incomplete. Here comes the 7th play now of this drive as this is 3rd and 10. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And he comes back with one complete. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. So the offense has it 1st and 10. And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. And now we get a timeout called on the defensive side of the ball by the Panthers. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. And the Panthers are going to take another timeout. So the defense had a chance to catch their breath, and now they're back out and ready. The 22 is the line to gain here on 3rd down. They'll drop the throw. Steps away to his left. And this is going to be incomplete.
Well, I've got to give him some credit there. He tried to sell the out route. He tried to sell it hard. And as a receiver, what you're really trying to do is maneuver a defender inside to give yourself a little more cushion breaking to the out. But how about the defender reading it really well, not buying the fake or the maneuver?
And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on. They go back to the ground now with Crowell. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. In on the tackle there, Luke Kuechly.
Well, he didn't make headway on that one, but he's had plenty of carries all night long. I just wonder if maybe he's a little bit tired from toting the rock that much.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And that's a touchdown as they've broken our tie here in the final minute of the fourth.
Did you see them hold up four fingers at the start of the fourth quarter?
They were ready.
They were definitely ready. They may or may not have done that, but they certainly have played that way. The fourth quarter has belonged to them, and now the lead belongs to them as well.
Well, Charles, exciting to the very end. That's what we just saw in this game. Final play there, had it in the red zone, but anytime you're outside of the 10, that's tough. Try to drop a final play to get in, and they couldn't do it.
It certainly is. So what they were looking for was, extra time. Too bad it's not FIFA soccer, right, where you get a little bit of extra and you get a chance to run up a couple more plays and maybe get closer and take that last shot into the end zone.
So for Cleveland, the streak continues as they push their mark to a perfect 12-0 now on the year. And they will hit the road next week for a date with the New Orleans Saints. Meanwhile, for the Panthers, it was a win they needed to turn the season around, but instead, they fall to 5-7. And they'll have a chance at redemption next week at home against the Los Angeles Rams. So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. It's a win for the Browns, and they're happy in the dog pound as we say so long from Cleveland.